Good morning. Myself Arun, Assistant Professor of EZ Department from Anna University Regional Campus, Madurai, Tamil Nadu. Today we are going to see about the topic optical amplifier. Optical amplifier is also working as like a normal audio amplifier. Instead of that normal audio amplifier, it having the additional equipment of optical converter in the input side and also in the output side. That means it works as an it receives the audio optical signal and converts it into the electrical signal. Then the amplifier amplifies the electrical signal. Then the amplified electrical signal is again converted into the optical signal. This is the nominal optical amplifier is working. The types of optical amplifiers. Raman amplifier is the famous one. The next one is the EDFA amplifier. Third one is YDFA amplifier, PDFA amplifier, TDFA amplifier. Depending upon the frequency operating ranges and the wavelength amplifying ranges, these amplifiers are described. And for that amplifier structure, it consists of transmitter, power amplifier, line amplifier, pre-amplifier and receiver unit. In between the transmitter and the receiver, the amplifier unit is installed. This amplifier unit is categorized as three types. One is the power amplifier, line amplifier and the pre-amplifier. The power amplifier and the line amplifier is used in the line itself for the power amplification and the line signal amplification purpose. But the pre-amplifier is used just behind the receiver unit to boost up the signal to before giving it to the receiver unit. Pre-amplifier, it is used in front of the receiver to improve the sensitivity of the receiver, high gain and sensitivity. Where the power amplifier, it is used to increase the output power, high power. Line amplifier, it is used in the middle of the link to compensate for link losses. Demerits and merits of the optical amplifier. A system with optical amplifiers can be more easily upgraded to higher bit rate. Without replacing the amplifiers, optical amplifiers have large gain bandwidths, key enabler of DWDM, and demerits. Amplifiers introduce additional noise that accumulates. Spectral shape of the gain, output power, transient behavior need to be carefully designed. And the mainly used fiber amplifier is the erbium doped fiber amplifier. Here, the conversion of optical to electrical and electrical to optical is totally avoided. In this erbium doped fiber amplifier, the optical signal is directly amplified as it is the optical signal with the help of a 980 nanometer pump. So normally this EDFA is works in the 1550 nanometer. So input signal is 1550 nanometer and the amplification purpose the pump is used as 980 nanometer. And the amplified output is isolated with the isolator and the signal is output. Why the EDF is preferred? EDF is provided most gain in the 1500 nanometer wavelength region. Same region where fiber attenuation is very lower, require pump light as shorter wavelengths, either 990 nanometer or the 1480 nanometer. But usually in the EDFA, we use 980 nanometer. It enables optical links over thousands of kilometers. Gain is not constant over the gain spectrum. In this slide, it shows the optical amplifier's flat gain region for the 20 channel, 40 channel, 80 channel and 60 channel. 200 GHz, 100 GHz separation and 50 GHz separation, 25 GHz separation respectively. Gain saturation in EDFA. Factors to be considered in designing an optical amplifier is the saturation of the amplifier. For high input powers, the EDFA tends to saturate and the gain drops. For low input power, the gain is unsaturated. For high input power, the gain gets saturated. Gain equation in EDFAs. This requires a large drive power, causes additional losses and power penalties. The preferred solution is to use optical fiber filter within the amplifier. Amplifier cascaders. instead of using the single amplifier, multiple amplifier increases the amplification process. The loss between the two stages exponential. As the number of stages increases, the SNR decreases gradually. If the unsaturated gain is large, amplifiers saturate and gain drops. A steady state condition is reached where output power and the gain remains constant. The saturated gain must be close to the loss. Compensating approach. Introducing an additional wavelength on the link which acts as a compensating wavelength. This is introduced at the beginning of the link and tapped off at the end. The power of this wavelength is increased to compensate for any decrease in input power. Disadvantage of this method is cost is high. Lacing loop. The system may lace if we are not careful with the closed fiber loop. If the total gain of the loop is comparable to the total loss in loop. This condition is similar to optical AGC. But lacing loops can cause power to be taken from live channel and distributed to channels that are lacing. This causes problems in ring network, which is inherently closed. Solutions to avoid lacing loops. Ensure that amplifier gain is lower than the loss being compensated. Ensure that closed loops never occur during the operation of system. Thank you.